Right now, just listening to my son's cries, my heart rate spikes, my pupils dilate, stress hormones flood my body. This reaction is ancient because the very survival of our species has depended upon our ability to hear that cry, interpret it, and respond. When we do this well, babies thrive. But when we don't, the cost lasts a lifetime. I'm a developmental cognitive neuroscientist and a mom of two. So I've seen in my lab and in my living room how early moments of connection set the blueprint for who we become. In these moments, something remarkable happens. Two nervous systems start learning each other through the back and forth rhythm of signal and response. And here's what science tells us. Brains are built, not born. The first 1,000 days from conception to toddlerhood are the single most critical window in all of human development. During this time, the brain forms up to 1 million new connections per second. But only the connections that get used stick around. That's how experience sculpts the brain, literally wiring our memories into matter. And those experiences reach even deeper. We used to think that DNA was destiny, but our DNA is not our destiny. Our genes are more like dimmable light switches, and experience is the hand that turns them up and down, writing the code for health and behavior across the lifetime. Loving touch, safe environments, responsive care, these light up pathways for growth. Toxic stress, neglect, chaos, they dim them. Resilience isn't magic. It's biology, built through thousands of moments where we turn down the stress and turn up the bonding by mating babies' signals with a human response. Now, it is easy enough for me to stand up here and say, don't stress, bond with baby. I totally get that that's easier said than done. I have a PhD in baby brains, and still, even for me, parenting is so hard. Birth rates are declining here and around the world as more and more people are choosing not to have children because of things like high costs and anxieties over an uncertain future. Parents today are struggling, stressed out, isolated, and increasingly turning to tech for help. So imagine this, a world where parenting requires no effort. You hand your newborn over to a machine that rocks, feeds, and soothes on schedule. No crying fits, no sleepless nights, no anxiety over getting it right. Does this sound like science fiction? Well, it's closer than you might think. Parents today are already using artificial intelligence to track sleep, time feeds, translate cries, and rock cribs. AI can analyze a baby's facial expressions and heart rate to tell the parent how the baby feels. But what will baby learn in this world? We have tested before what happens when care becomes mechanical. Decades ago, psychologist Harry Harlow gave baby monkeys two pseudo-mothers. One was made of wire and provided milk, and the other was covered in soft cloth but offered no food at all. Overwhelmingly, the infants clung to the cloth mother, consistently choosing comfort over nutrition. This study taught us something profound. Babies don't just need care, they need connection. Later, work by Amanda Woodward and others showed us that even very young infants understand intention. They track your eyes, your hands, your timing, and they learn that people act on purpose. A machine might rock, feed, and respond, but it can't mean to. And that's what the baby brain is really wired to learn, not just that someone is there, but that someone chose to be there. For the developing brain, it's not about perfection. It's about intention. Those imperfect human moments, the missed cues, the retries, the giggles through the tears, that's the messy dance where strong brains are built. In fact, in my lab, we've shown that the healthy infant brain is beautifully noisy. That noise, that variability, is the signature of flexibility, the freedom to explore, fail, adapt. If we try to optimize every moment, we risk losing that noise. And with it, we risk raising children who are efficient, but brittle, predictable, but not resilient. And that right there is the difference between a mind and a machine. But AI doesn't need to replace care. It can help us restore it. In neonatal intensive care units, AI systems are already saving lives by detecting distress before it's visible to the human eye. And in my own lab, we're developing precision parenting tools that use AI to support mothers with postpartum depression, helping them learn to tune their touch and their timing to their baby's signals. But when I say precision, I don't mean perfection. I mean personalization. Using technology not to replace the parent, but to help restore the synchrony that stress can disrupt. That's AI at its best, when it can help us turn down the stress so we can focus on turning up the bonding. But there is a catch. If we let AI remove every struggle, we also remove the learning. Because even stress follows a Goldilocks rule. Too much stress and the system shuts down. But too little stress and there's no motivation to change. The Yerkes-Dodson law tells us that growth and learning happens in the middle, where challenge meets support. So if we want to raise resilient humans that AI can never replace, we don't need new parenting gadgets or hacks. We need to return to the biology that built us. It really comes down to three rules every parent can follow starting from the very beginning. Rule one, turn down the stress. Before and after birth, stress chemistry leaves molecular fingerprints on a child's DNA, tuning those genetic dimmer switches and wiring the brain. AI may be rewriting society, but parents are still rewriting the genome every single day with our love and our stress. So take care of yourself as fiercely as you care for your child. Step outside, ask for help, lower the stress before trying to add connection. It's not just self-care, it's brain care for your baby. Rule two, increase the bonding. Respond to the cry, the coo, the giggle. These are critical bids for attention, where baby is exploring how their actions shape the world and the people around them. Now, the response doesn't have to be perfect or even come every time. What matters is that the world answers back with a human response most of the time. So put down your phone, make eye contact, smile, be the response. And finally, rule three, preserve the noise. Trying, failing, adapting, this variability is the foundation for creativity, empathy, and resilience. So let your baby safely explore the world. Expose them to new environments, sensations, and people. Because every new experience tunes a noise that keeps the brain alert, curious, and ready to learn. If we hand that learning over to perfect algorithms, we trade human complexity for mechanical order and lose the very thing that makes us human. When I pick up my crying son, something really special happens. His heart rate slows, his stress hormones fall. Our bodies synchronize, two nervous systems in duet. Even before words, his brain is learning a critical lesson. Do cries bring comfort or not? That question, repeated 1,000 times a day in tiny moments of care, set him up for a lifetime of human connection. Because unlike algorithms, as parents, we don't optimize, we love. Imperfectly, but with intention. That's the difference. The future of AI isn't just about algorithms and machines. It's about how we raise the humans who grow up alongside them. The AI future does not begin when your child first logs in. It begins before they're even born. The first 1,000 days are a one-time opportunity, not to prepare a child for a specific technology, but for a lifetime of adaptation. AI will keep changing, but the baby brain once built cannot be rebuilt. That's why the real AI revolution, the one that will define our humanity, begins in the nursery. Let's raise babies who are more human than a machine could ever be. Thank you.